Get ready to alter all your preconceived ideas of Russian life. This is a country in the midst of an evolution from old world traditions to modern conveniences. The old guard to free thinkers. This once communist society now has rich, poor, and most importantly, an upwardly mobile middle class. Almost everyone here can have a taste of the high life, especially when it comes to the food.
After centuries of political and economic upheaval, the one constant for the Russian family has always been the cuisine. The wild card in all this has been the post-perestroika abundance. The meal still centers around meat and potatoes because they're the perfect comfort food for the long Russian winters. The St. Petersburg restaurants, well, it's an international city, so they still cater to young people, business types, and tourists. But if you ask any Russian, they'll tell you they still like to do things the old-fashioned way.
The advantage of visiting St. Petersburg in July is that the sun only dips past the horizon for a couple of hours. This phenomenon is called the white nights, and the amphetamine effect on the psyche keeps the action hopping at all hours. No matter when you cruise along the Never River or stroll past the famous architecture, landmarks, and museums, like the Hermitage, the city's main street is always busy. Taking in the sights of St. Petersburg, you can't help but notice similarities between this city and a famous Italian port city. Nicknamed the Venice of the North, St. Petersburg is actually situated on dozens of individual islands with hundreds of bridges drawing all the pieces together. It's a spectacular puzzle featuring some of the finest architectural styles of the 17th and 19th centuries. And when it comes to exquisite hotels, well, this is the jewel in Europe's crown. The marble floors, stained glass, even the furniture and artwork. All of it is authentic and true to the hotel's 1875 roots, blended in with all the creature comforts of the modern era. Every room here tells a story, according to hotel manager Thomas Knoll.
Yeah, this is our famous billiard room, not because we play billiard here anymore nowadays, but a lot of famous meetings are happening in this room. I would say it's probably the most secure meeting room in town.
The hotel is not just a business destination, but is also one of the finer places to dine in this city. They're renowned for their signature handmade chocolates, their extensive vodka selection, award-winning Cuban cigars, but it's my desire to indulge in one of the world's great delicacies that brings me here. What better place to start than in the kitchen? The chef is whipping up one of his signature dishes called an egg in egg. He mixes in fresh cream, pepper, salt, and chives. Sort of a deviled egg concoction, and then spoons it back into the cleaned shell.
Oh, wow.
And then, voila, the Russian caviar.
That is beautiful.
Thank you.
Oh, my Lord. The nice thing is that the quality of the eggs are as good as the quality of the caviar. Wow.
Caviar is Russia's most revered culinary contribution to the world. For hundreds of years, the deep, cold seas surrounding this country have provided excellent breeding grounds for the sturgeon fish. These large fish are the source of the quality roe, or eggs, that once salted, become caviar. As a result, caviar is considered an international symbol of culinary elitism, and people come to St. Petersburg for the privilege of tasting it.
How long ago was this processed?
I would say not more than 2 weeks ago.
Wow.
The fish was still in the water of this caviar.
Wow.
It's very fresh, you can see it, you can smell it. It still has the smell of the sea, basically. This has much less salt in it.
Oh, it is, and it does, it smells like rocks on the beach.
Yeah.
Just glorious.
Yeah.
I believe the caviar bar is calling my name.
Now, in the finest caviar restaurant in St. Petersburg, prices range from almost $200 an ounce for the best beluga caviar to almost $100 an ounce for the best sevruga caviar. But when in St. Petersburg, it's usually a good idea to go with the tasting plate.
The tasting plate features the salted fish roe from three different species of sturgeon: the Sevruga, the smallest and most abundant sturgeon, the Ocetra, a larger fish featuring a nutty flavor, and the largest and most prized of all, the Beluga. The latter is an endangered species in many other places around the world. The fish can live to be 100 years old, but females only start producing eggs after age 20. I've ordered a half ounce of each caviar, measured precisely at the table. The waiter suggests a garnish of egg yolks and whites, a dab of sour cream, and several blinis, Russia's version of the crepe. I'm eating the portions from right to left, from the smallest sized eggs to the largest, allowing myself to build up to the beluga caviar. So I start with the Sevruga.
You're welcome, sir.
A little blini and a little dollop of sour cream. Here goes. The Sevruga's briny. It's very, very mild and not half as salty as any other Sevruga I've ever eaten in my entire life. Extremely high quality, very, very fresh. All right, on to the Ocetra, which generically speaking is my favorite caviar. And if you look very closely, you can see that golden green fish oil that came out of those eggs. That's how rich and divinely decadent Ocetra caviar can be. That's a sign of very high quality. A much bolder flavor, a much nuttier finish. That's really awesome. It's like concentrated essence of the ocean. I like that. All right. And now, a little bit of the beluga caviar. God, look at how gorgeous the egg structure is on that. Hello, boys. The quality of the flavor of that beluga was absolutely incredible. A much more assertive flavor than the other caviars. Bigger, bolder, not necessarily saltier, just more of a pure sort of fish egg flavor. It really is an indescribable and singular taste. Ooh, this is good.
I think the most appropriate way to end this decadent evening is a trip to the lobby bar and a taste of one more Russian classic, beef stroganoff. Created in late 19th century Russia, authentic beef stroganoff is a ragu of beef, onions, and sour cream.
Braised beef, caramelized onions, sour cream. This is hearty. When you're riding across the Russian steppes during a cold, hard winter, this is what you want to fortify yourself with.